hardest ticket to get in these parts in ages, and the folks that are packed into this place are making an impact already. It's Game 3 of the World Series between the New York Yankees and the Atlanta Braves. Hi again, everybody. Matt Vaskirjian. Welcome to the World Series here on MLB Network. With me is Mark DeRosa and Dan Plesac. And Dan, lots to talk about here as we get ready for Game 3.
You know, I think the phrase must win is overused in sports. But even though this isn't an elimination game, it does sort of feel like a must win. Doesn't matter what sport you're talking about. If you go down 3-0 in any series, you're fighting nearly an impossible uphill battle. Feels like the series kind of rides on this game right here.
The buildup to this one is just about over. It's time for all the drama of World Series baseball on MLB Network. And we'll have it all for you next. Side about to take the field. This place is jumping. Here's public address announcer Alex Miniak.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Atlanta Braves.
Now we'll look at the two guys who'll get the ball here in Game 3. With that, here's a look at the Yankees' starting lineup. Who are you focused on, Dan Plesac?
Well, Matt, keep an eye on that number two spot. I mean, this guy is a career 300 hitter. You talk about consistent. He delivers a good at-bat and clutch hits basically every time he walks into the box. I love watching this guy.
John Smoltz gets the ball in Game 3 of the series. What do we need to know here, Danny?
Hey, he wasn't particularly good in his last one. If you look at the line score, he only lasted 4 innings, took the loss. He'll really be hoping to turn in a much better performance in this one.
All right, the Atlanta Braves attack you on defense this way. Hey, let's focus on Freddie Freeman, first baseman for the Atlanta Braves. He plays one of the most reliable first basemen in the game, makes the routine play. Not only that, he can pick and grin, saving his infielders some serious errors.
Leading off tonight for the Yankees, the shortstop, Derek Jeter.
Here's the pitch. Zero. In there for strike one.
First pitch, 7:07.
Line to the right side. Well, this is gloved over there at first as he was in the right spot at the right time. One away.
The second baseman. Number 25.
Pitch of the at-bat. Back up the middle. Swanson scoops it up. On to first, and there are two down.
Batting third. The left fielder. David Rosario.
Well, first pitch to him. Not close with the off-speed pitch taken for a ball. So let's take a peek at the umpiring crew in this one. Behind the plate is Ricky Holiday.
Hey, D-Ro, you better be up there ready to swing with Ricky Holiday behind the plate, particularly on that high pitch.
Yeah, and I don't like that, Dan. As an offensive player, that's the one pitch that you almost can't get to with a power guy on the mound.
The throw is in time to get him to retire the side. 1-2-3 go the Bombers. And now the Braves will get their initial shot here. No score. And time now to take a look at how these Braves are lined up in this one. Who's the one to watch, Dan?
Well, Matt, I'm excited to get a chance to see that left-handed hitter, Freddie Freeman. He doesn't let the pressure of the big moment get to him. I love watching this guy hit in clutch situations. It's like he takes a deep breath and everything stops in front of him. He plays like the Zen man.
James Paxton will do the pitching in Game 3 of the series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Boy, there's lots to like about this lefty, James Paxton. Big arm from the left side. He reminds me a lot of Andy Pettit. The only thing, he throws about 4 or 5 miles harder than Pettit. Paxton occasionally 97 to 98 miles an hour. Good hard overhand curveball. His changeup is getting better the more he uses it. This is one of the game's premier left-handed strikeout pitchers.
Into the box now, David Justice. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
For the Braves, the right fielder, David Justice.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And a ball, 1-0. Here it comes on 1-1. And that's taken for a called strike two.
Wow, there's a pitch right there that this guy would like to have back. Very rarely do you see a pitcher of this quality throw one right down the middle. And boy, he took that one. He'd like to have that one back and be able to take a good hack at that pitch.
Well, this will be taken in out there at short, and that's the first out of the inning. First offering on its way. Line drive to center field. Gardner is there. Two gone. And with two away, let's give you one more look at the pads these two teams took to get to this Game 3 of the World Series. Pitch coming. Here it is. And this is just off the outside corner for a ball, 1-0. Two out, nobody on. And it's fouled away.
I know it's a guessing game, but usually when you flip that coin, it better come up fastball at this level. You cannot be late right there. That was right in the wheelhouse.
One ball and two strikes to count. The 1-2. High in the air down the right field line. Judge will get there and he puts it away to retire the side. Braves failed to score in the first. We'll head to the second now at SunTrust Park. No score here on the show.
Lead off of the Yankees, the right fielder, Aaron.
Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. Up and away to start the inning. It's 1-0. Judge, who fittingly gets the nickname All Rise, he was selected in the first round back in the draft of 2013.
Yeah, Matt, you cannot miss on your first rounder. And they
swung on and crushed. Everyone just stands there and watches it fly. A solo home run there for Aaron Judge. His second home run of the series as the Yankees will grab a 1-0 lead.
Hey, listen, there's an old adage in baseball that solo home runs won't kill you. This is one of the top hitters in that lineup. So a home run, a solo home run right here, it's not the end of the world.
Into the box now, Gary Sanchez.
Gary,
as he will look at a first pitch fastball for ball one.
Hey, I know there's a lot of game left, but that is such an important run there in the top of the first. Try and silence this crowd. I can't tell you, in postseason play, one run feels like three or four.
Popped him up. Flowers waits on it. He's got it one away.
Batting fifth, the first baseman, John Mattingly.
Into the box now, Don Mattingly. One run in and one gone so far this inning. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Line drive snagged on a short hop. On to Freeman at first, and there are two away now.
Man, you can't hit a ball any harder than that. I mean, this ball gets on him in a heartbeat. Nice job to stay with it, though, and then make the out at first.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. Hit to third. Right to Donaldson. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. Yankees are off and running early thanks to the solo home run. We'll go to the bottom of the second. It's now 1-0 New York. Stepping into the box, Josh Donaldson will start things out against James Paxton as we get the inning underway. First pitch of the at-bat. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike.
As this game progresses, I don't think he's going to want to miss in that spot down the middle of the plate much more. It's early. They're a little less aggressive right now, so he's able to get away with it.
And quickly, there's one down to lead off the frame.
Batting fifth, the center fielder, Dale Murphy.
First pitch on its way. And that misses ball one. Now the 1-0 is taken for ball two.
Two balls, no strikes.
Hits this one hard the other way. And there is the first hit of the ball game for the Braves.
Hey, one of the things that makes it so tough to pitch is you consistently have to make good pitches. Even on 2-0, you just can't lay one right down the middle.
Yeah, I'm sure he wanted to nip a corner right there, but hats off challenging 2-0 in a fastball count. He came and got some.
Here's the first pitch to him. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. And he is in there.
Well, it's really hard to complain about this one because that's one of the hardest double plays to turn. The first baseman has to deal with the runner headed to second, and he sometimes shields you from throwing where you want to make the throw. They should have made it, but that's a tough play all the way around.
Delivery to him on the way. A high fastball is in there.
Hey, when you're in a tough spot right there, that's an excellent job by the pitcher to get ahead 0-1. He has now got this offensive player on the defensive.
Backhanded to second for one. On to first. Not in time as he just hits the bag ahead of the throw.
That was kind of a high degree of difficulty to play that time. You see the off-balance throw to second base, and he couldn't get a lot on it, but they did get the out.
The catcher, Tyler Flowers, as the changeup to him drops in there for the first strike. Two's all over the place. Two on, two out, and of course, here in inning number two. Good breaking ball there, laid off for the second strike.
He certainly hasn't been the aggressor in this at bat. Two straight takes, so now we'll see if he can change his approach and battle up.
Line drive to left. In there, base hit, and that ought to get the run in from third.
Dan, as a former infielder, I apologize for him. Nothing's more frustrating or upset you more as a defender than making an error and seeing that guy come around to score.
You know what? And that's one of those cases as a pitcher, D-Ro. There's not much you can do. Listen, there are physical and there are mental errors. And you just have to, as a pitcher, go ahead and look past that now and try to pick up your teammate and try to get it out any way you can.
John Smoltz is at the plate as he takes a cold strike one. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. Hard liner, but picked up on a hot throw on the second for the force, and the side is retired. I have to imagine there's a full moon tonight, judging by this bunch. Back with more from Game 3 after this. Now at the plate, Brett Gardner, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one.
Number 11, Brett Gardner.
First pitch coming, here it is. This is line to left, and Gardner's going to reach. It's a base hit. So the leadoff hitter's aboard. Pitcher due up. Looks to be a textbook sacrifice situation.
Hey, some guys can handle the postseason lights, and this is obviously one of them. Another base hit leading off for the boys. This guy's had a monster postseason so far.
Into the box, James Paxton. And now a bunt attempt here as he gets this one down. And good hustle to get over and tag him for the out.
The sacrifice was in order right there as he gets the bunt down right there. And sometimes it's easier to just tag him instead of making that throw to first base.
Standing in now, Derek Jeter as he rips it on the ground to second. And that's through into right field for a base hit. And not in time as the run scores.
Boy, that has to feel good as a hitter, D. Where you get that base hit to give your team the lead. You have to feel good when you get down to first base.
Yeah, it's just a nice approach. You see him turn to his boys right there and get fired up with the dugout. 100%. Not trying to do too much. Able to quiet the moment down, center himself, and come through in a big spot.
Before the first pitch, a check at first. And he'll get dirty, but he's back in safely. In now, Torres fouled away. Torres is one of the few true superstar hitters in the game. You're no doubt aware of it, but it doesn't matter who he's facing. He's a major league threat to hit the ball hard somewhere just about every time he steps into the box.
Yeah, one of the best hitters.
And hold on there. He got him. Tried to swipe second base, but he's gunned down for the out.
So they put the speedster in motion. They're trying to test this catcher, who isn't known for his throwing abilities, but they had it sniffed out. A well-executed pitch out leads to a good throw, and they nab him at second.
Now the 1-1 pitch. And this one's hit on the ground, but foul. Bases are empty here with two men out. And a curveball swung on and missed, and a great call there as the inning is over. A run on two hits for the Yankees. We'll move on to the bottom of inning number three. The Yankees lead it 2-1. Digging in for his second at bat, David Justice. He'll get us going in the home half of inning number three. Paxton has his sign. Here comes the first pitch. Right side. Torres from the outfield grass. Throw on the first in time, one away.
Now batter. The shortstop. Dempsey.
So one gone for the Braves here in the third. And that brings up the former number one overall pick, Dansby Swanson. And a fastball is in there for strike one.
Expect the guy on the mound to keep attacking his zone right here. He has a chance for a quick inning. He is not nibbling. Everything is catching those 17 inches.
Nine, that's a base hit in the left field.
Pitcher went to the well one too many times. Back-to-back fastballs. Now hitter was able to keep his hands through, deliver a nice line drive.
Freeman.
Here's the first baseman, Freddie Freeman, as he'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half. It's 0-1. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout. A ball and a strike now to the Braves' first baseman.
And the reason he's working away so much here is because he's got that big hole on the right side of the infield to worry about. With the first baseman holding the runner on, it's always smart to pitch into the defense you have behind you.
And that's the second out.
Now batting, third baseman, Josh Donaldson.
Now to the plate, Josh Donaldson, as he'll look to bring home that tying run from second with a base hit into the outfield. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1.
You know, Matty, when I first broke into the league, you wouldn't see that high heater first pitch right out of the gate. But I think there's been a change in philosophy here. Back in the late 90s, early 2000s, guys wanted to attack you more east-west, get you leaning left-right. Now you're seeing guys attack.
And the center fielder is under it to make the catch, and the inning is over. One left for Atlanta. They're down 2-1. So stepping stepping in, David Rosario comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ballgame.
David Rosario.
First pitch of the at bat. Line towards center field. And that's a base hit. So a little first pitch swing in there as he's on to kick off the inning.
Hey guys, there had to be something in the scouting report right there. For him to be on top of that 0-0 change up the way he was, that was pretty special.
Aaron Judge.
Here's big Aaron Judge as he's reaching at a curveball and comes up empty at strike one. Perhaps he can drive another one out of the park just like he did back in the second. From the belt, the pitch hit hard back up the middle. The second for one on to Freeman, the double play.
Really good pitch from the pitcher right there. Down in the zone, hits on top of it, induces the ground ball double play.
Stepping in now, Gary Sanchez. And there's a swing and a miss at an off-speed pitch to start him out. Nothing in one. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. Weak grounder back to the mound. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. One hit's all they get. To the bottom of inning number four we go. The Yankees lead this one 2-1. Dale Murphy. He singled his last time up.
The center fielder, Dale.
Paxton's ready. First pitch on the way. Swung on and missed. It's 0-1.
This guy's been on cruise control as we head into the middle innings of this one. And one of the big factors why? How about 80% of his first pitches have been for strikes?
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Down low, two balls and a strike. Now the 2-1 pitch. And opposite field as he lines this down the line and right. And now this will get over the wall. Down the line out there for a ground rule double.
Just a great approach at the plate right there. Takes that pitch on the outer half and goes with it. He clearly hit it well because it bounced right over the wall for a ground rule double.
Into the box now, Ron Gant, line to the right side. He's 0-for-1 thus far. The 0-1 pitch. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Fourth inning of a 2-1 ball game. And he fouls this one off. The 0-2 once more. The next 0-2 misses, and that'll move it to 1-2 now. Knuckle curve, and he can't ring him up as it goes to 2-2.
Hey, I appreciate the fact that he's making him throw a few pitches. Most of his teammates have been hacking at everything that comes their way.
Count remains 2-2. And look out, as that fastball ran in and got him. Armstrong.
Yeah, it was a great battle there, and he was one strike away from putting him away as a pitcher. You hate to put a guy on for free after all that work.
And that'll bring in the former top prospect, Ozzie Albies. Lifted in the air out towards left center. Gardner is in retreat as he pulls it in for the first out. And he'll indeed move up 90 feet, putting runners at the corners now with one away.
Good read there at second base to know he could make it to third on the flyout. Now he's only 90 feet away with one out.
Riding in once again, Tyler Flowers, as he's got a chance to tie this ball game up with that equalizing run just 90 feet away at third. In there, and it's 0-1.
First and third, you know he's going to do everything he can on the mound to roll up a double play ball. On the other side, he's got to be looking for a mistake up in the zone that he can drive in the air and pick up a sack fly at the very least.
Hits are now even at four apiece. A ball and two strikes, the count to Tyler Flowers.
With two strikes and the runners at the corners, this is a big pitch coming up. Got to execute and hope to either get a strikeout or a double play ball to help you get out of this thing.
And he struck him out.
He's not going to feel good about that at bat, nor should he. You have to want to swing the bat, but he just stood there and looked at four straight pitches. Hopefully, we'll see him get a little bit more aggressive next time.
Into the box, John Smoltz, as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. And there are runners at the corners now. Swing and a liner, and this is going to be a fair ball as it'll head to the corner, and this will find a wall deep in the corner. And the score is the runner from first. It's a 3-2 ball game.
Boy, that's a big base hit right there, Duval, by the pitcher to give them a one-run lead.
Yeah, that's a backbreaker for the team right now. They're going to have to find a way to regroup. When you watch the pitcher drive in two, nothing can be more frustrating. And to give up the lead in that manner, you know your manager's steaming right now.
In now, David Justice, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. No hits to this point. Now the 0-1. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul. So a missed opportunity there. Smoltz, the runner at first with two gone. Grounded down the third baseline. But this will be a foul ball and it's still 0-2. Fouled off. Here comes another 0-2. That's inside and low. It's a ball and two strikes.
I can't blame him one bit out on the mound. I'm shocked he didn't pick up the rosin bag and see if he could get a foul ball on that one. He had to see if he would swing way outside the zone.
He's set. Here's the 2-2. Now a fastball as he just reared up and let that one fly, and the inning is over. So it's two runs on two hits, no errors, and a runner left. On to the top of inning number five we go. It's the Braves 3 and the Yankees 2. Welcome back to SunTrust Park, just outside of Atlanta, as we send it down to check in with Heidi.
Thanks, Matt. I talked with Yankees manager Aaron Boone during the break about the team's offensive performance so far, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. He said they've been chasing at pitches out of the zone all game, which obviously doesn't usually lead to good results. Until they start being more selective with their swings, he said they will continue to struggle.
All right, Heidi, thank you. First pitch on its way. All over that one, but a little out in front. Foul ball. And it's fouled away. Oh, and two count. Here's the pitch. And here's a ball hit in the air. Gant is after it, and they can't run it down. Oh, and two, here it comes. And he popped him up. in there, a base hit.
Well, you know what? Good hitters are good hitters for a reason, D-Row. And to be able to hang in there on an 0-2 pitch and still be able to get a base hit, this guy's about as good as it gets.
Yeah, I'm blown away by this guy, Dan. You wouldn't know if you showed up. You wouldn't know if it's 2-0, 3-1, 0-2. Counts do not matter. This guy trusts in his craft.
Here's the second baseman, DJ LeMahieu. One ball, no strikes to count. Hits are even right now at five aside. Hit in the air down the right field line. But this will wind up being a foul ball. The set and the 1-1 pitch. Well hit to right, but a foul ball. Breaks his bat as this one's popped up, and he'll steer clear of the flying debris to make the catch here for the first out.
Next for the Yankees, the center fielder, Brett.
So a runner at first with one man gone, and up next, the left-handed hitting Brett Gardner. Ready with the first pitch, here it comes. Just able to get a piece of that for strike one. Fifth inning of play here in a 3-2 ball game. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one-out double.
Yeah, some guys have the ability to rise the occasion while some guys shrink away when it matters the most. Well, this guy is a gamer. He's been on fire since the postseason started, and after that hit, it looks like he doesn't plan on stopping anytime soon.
Stepping in now, James Paxton, as he will take strike one on the fastball here. No balls and a strike. He did his job and laid down the successful sack bunt in his first appearance. A one pitch on its way. And he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Hey, as an offense, you do your homework, you scout. He hasn't been using that pitch an awful lot. I say you just throw that out. If he's going to flip that occasionally for a strike, then so be it.
From the stretch. Fouled away. Two runs, six hits, and one error on the Yankee line score so far. And he chased it in the dirt. Flowers has it, and he makes the throw to first. Paxton is retired, two down now.
Good pitch there, and that was a nice job by his battery mate to complete the play first after the ball hit the dirt.
Standing in now, Derek Jeter, as with two away, he'll swing and miss at the first pitch. It's 0-1. He's working on a 1-for-2 game so far. And he turns this one around high and deep to center field. And this one is gone, a home run. So a three-run blast to deep center here. His first homer here in the series, and it's now 6-3.
That's what I love about baseball. The pitch before, he looked absolutely foolish, but he gathered himself, stayed with the plan, and the next pitch he goes yard. Every pitch is another chance.
Into the box, Torres. As the first pitch to him is off the plate for a ball, 1-0. 0-for-2 from him so far in this one. The 1-0 home. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Moving under it, Justice. And the inning is over. Another look at the big blow for the Bombers. A three-run home run. Middle of the night here at SunTrust Park. It's now 5-3 New York. And next will be Dansby Swanson digging in. And Dan, he and his fellow top of the order hitters haven't really offered much help for this lineup so far.
No, your 1-2-3 guys are the ones you look to generate a lot of action. And they just haven't been up to the task so far in this one. Still time for them to turn it around, though. We'll see if it happens.
Well out in front of the breaking ball there for a strike.
Back-to-back breaking balls. He just missed that one right there, fouling it away. Do not expect a third.
Hit on the ground is short. Jeter comes up with it. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out. So coming to the plate, Freddie Freeman. First offering on its way. Fastball over the outside, but in there for a strike.
He might want that pitch back up and away. That's a pitch you can really drive if you have the right approach towards that opposite field gap.
Fastball, and he's quickly in the hole, 0-2.
Even though he let that one go, you know that's the kind of pitch he likes to take a big hack at. Not too many power hitters that don't like a stomach-high fastball, so he's probably not throwing that one again.
Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. And a fastball blew it right by him, and they're two down. Didn't mess around much in that at bat, Dan.
No, that was pretty impressive, Matt. I really like a pitcher that trusts and works off his fastball. Right there, he decided he didn't need to use anything else. Three straight heaters and go grab some bench.
Here's the third baseman, Josh Donaldson. 0-2 on his line thus far. Here comes the first pitch. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Three runs, five hits, and no errors so far for Atlanta. A 1-1 count now to Donaldson.
Still a little bit early to be worrying about this, but in a two-run game, a two-out walk right here could at least get the tying run to the plate. And on top of that, there's some pop on that on-deck circle.
Popped him up. Sanchez over to his right. No trouble with this one, and the inning is over. Pretty painless half of the inning all told. We're through five here at the ballpark. The Yankees lead it 5-3. Darren O'Day takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound.
Number 59, Darren O'Day.
David Rosario, as the switch hitter, will take his cuts left-handed here.
Rosario.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. High in the air and deep to left center field. But that'll hit off the wall in left center. And the Yankees are in business here. It's a leadoff double.
Hey, this guy's having a big series in the postseason. It looks like to me that the moment isn't too big for him. He's slowing the game down. He looks terrific.
Yeah, absolutely. Postseason monster right here, having a huge series. Any big leaguer can have their moment mid-May, but to do it when it gets cold outside means everything.
Aaron Judge will stand in here hoping to duplicate what he did back in the second inning as we flash you back to take another look at his solo home run that helped get this offense rolling. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Down the third baseline. But a foul ball here, 0-1. Now a pick walk-off play at second, and he'll get back in standing. Rosario stands at second with no outs.
Can't imagine he comes back with a third breaking ball. That hitter looked like he timed that one up pretty well and just missed it, fouling it away.
And this is swung on and missed, and boy, they took care of a key man there. One away.
It's so hard to hit when you're behind the count 0-2, right? You have to protect for the fastball. You have to look for the soft stuff down and away. You're really at a disadvantage when you fall behind 0-2.
In now, Gary Sanchez, as he'll go after the first pitch and bounce it into foul territory. Second here with one man out. And it's 0-2 to Sanchez. So back-to-back sliders for strikes. Does he come back with yet another?
There's another slider. That's back-to-back good sliders. And this guy's breaking ball is really good. And when he's throwing it well like he is and he's confident with it, he can throw it three or four times in a row. A really good slider in this one.
Hoping to send him packing. Pitch on its way. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away.
Now, after back-to-back strikouts, he's got a real good chance of making that leadoff double pretty much meaningless. He's made some good pitches, and these hitters have really failed driving him in or at least getting him over.
Into the box now, Don Mattingly. He offers at it and hits it in the air to left. And he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. One left for the Yankees as they hang on to their 5-3 lead. Settling in now, Dale Murphy. He'll lead it off as we start the home sixth.
Things not looking very good so far in this one, but we're still in the middle innings. They're down by a couple of runs, and this would be the right place and the right time to get something going. The last thing they want to do is to try to come from behind and win this one in the eighth or ninth inning.
He's got to be more disciplined here. It's 0-2.
I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's his windup. I don't know if it's just flat stuff. But he's getting a lot of swings outside the zone, and he's having a big game.
Paxton has his sign. Here's the 0-2. Stays alive, still 0-2. And he takes strike three called on the fastball. One gone.
Tell you, he's showing no signs of tiring right now. Still looks razor sharp from what I can tell. So I think he might last a while longer if he can keep this up.
Digging in, Ron Gant. He was drilled by a pitch his last time up.
Yeah, Matty, you're not lying. Last time up, squared right in the back. Hopefully it doesn't stiffen up. I want to see if he can get through something right here.
And that's inside for a ball. 1-0. Low and away as he misses again, 2-0. Down the first baseline, and that's through for a hit. The throw into second, and he's able to hustle his way up the second as he'll reach here with a two-base hit.
As we look again at that bubble here, you can see that he was thinking too right out of the box. Smashed it down the line, and that was some great hustle to beat the throw to second to earn himself a double.
So striding forward now, Ozzie Albies. He flew out in his last at-bat. second. Here's the pitch. Pitch misses the throw down. The tag's there, and he's out trying to steal third. Great throw.
I noticed he had a big lead there at second, so I wasn't surprised when he took off, but that lead didn't pay off as he still gets caught trying to swipe third.
Two out, nobody on. Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center. Gardner is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Braves go down quietly. Still a two-run deficit. It's 5-3. Back here at SunTrust Park. On to the seventh now in Game 3. But before it gets underway, we take a look at our game summary through the first six. Now we're going to have a conference at the home plate area, so it would appear that we'll see a double switch here. Ladies, Jesse Biddle is on the pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number seven
for Atlanta. Now pitching and batting in the sixth spot. Number 63.
Digging in once again, DJ LeMahieu. He was retired after popping out in his last at bat.
Yeah, I don't mind him trying to drive the ball in the air, but he can't collapse the backside, and that's exactly what he did in his last at bat. Look for him to stay a little taller and keep that upper half a little bit more over him.
Come on, guys, let's go.
The 0-1 hard liner to center field. Murphy has to roam straight back, but he has it for the first down.
Good contact to start out the inning. Thought he might be on base with some sort of a hit, but it hung up there too long. Just unlucky that time.
Here's Brett Gardner now, as he'll take a look at ball one. Two hits in two trips for him thus far. Here it comes, 1-0. Pulls this one into the air, out into right field. Justice is there, two down.
Now batting, the pitcher, James Paxton.
Standing in now, the pitcher, James Paxton. So with two away, they decide to let him hit instead of burning a pinch hitter. And he'll step out and ask for time. Maybe trying to get this pitcher out of the rhythm he's in right now. Giancarlo Stanton will get the call to pinch hit here, as we'll see what he can do with two out and the bases empty.
Giancarlo Stanton.
Oh, and one the count. Bases are empty here with two men out. Weak grounder down the line at third. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. So the Yanks go 1-2-3, and it remains 5-3. Dylan Betances gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Digging in, Tyler Flowers. 1-for-2 on his line so far in the game.
Even though we're moving into the back end of this game, they're only down by a couple of runs. You know that old slogan, a bloop and a blast? They could certainly use that right now.
Betances sets, 1-0 on its way. And he misses again, 2-0. That'll find its way out of play. Still going to have a good hitter's count, 2-1 now. The 2-1 is strike two, swinging.
That's straight smoke at 99, guys. It's almost unfair.
And Swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
You know what was really impressive to me about that strikeout? He fell behind 2-0 to start the at-bat. That's a pretty bad place to be, but then he kind of refocused himself and came right back with three quality pitches in a row to sit him down. That's not easy to do, but now his focus has to hone in on getting ahead on the next guy.
Ender Inciarte is at the plate as he looks at ball one. Bases are empty, one man out. Now a fastball for a called strike. It's 1-1. And he fouls this one off. The 1-2. Hit in the air down the left field line. And this will wind up a foul ball. The 1-2 fouled off. Just off the outside that time, laid off for a ball.
Tough to take a pitch like that right there, especially in a 1-2 count. You almost get in that auto swing mode. Great job to work the count back to even.
Full count to Ender Inciarte, three balls and two strikes. Eighth pitch of the at-bat coming up. And it's fouled away. Ready? Now the payoff pitch. And he takes ball four. So a good job out of the nine hole in getting on base as we go back to the top of the order.
Now batting, right fielder, David.
Now back to the leadoff spot in the Braves lineup. Stepping in, David Justice. No hits in three tries so far. He's struck out once. First pitch of the at-bat. Can't find the zone there as he lays off the breaking ball.
This is one of those classic cases of the right guy at the right spot. They need to get a rally going, and this is maybe their best hitter. So he's the right guy in the right spot for this team right now.
The 1-1. This is hit high in the air out toward left center. Calling for it, Rosario. Two gone. At the plate, Dansby Swanson. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
Ooh, shines him off with that one. And that will conclude matters here in the seventh. Braves strand one. They're still down 5-3. Leading off the inning, Derek Jeter, as they'll look for some added insurance before the bottom half of the inning.
Jeter.
First pitch on its way. Now a swing and a fly ball. But this will land untouched. Hit hard on the ground at first. And this is going to find its way into right for a base hit. The leadoff man's on to start the eighth.
Hey, this guy's obviously seeing the ball right now. That's another hard hit single. 3-for-4 right there. He's looking super solid at the plate.
Ready once again, Torres. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Almost, Matty. Almost went deep his last AB. Certainly just missed it. With this guy's big power, he's feeling pretty good at the dish. Look for him to try and get on something and drive it out of the yard this AB.
Couldn't resist on that one, and he's behind nothing and one.
Well, they've really had an answer for keeping him in check in this series. He's offered very little resistance with the bat in his hand so far.
Into the corner and slicing foul. The 0-2 delivery in the air to straightaway center field. Murphy sprinting after it. He can't get to it. This one's down. And he'll just beat the throw to second. He's in there.
And right here you see a situation where no doubles defense comes back to bite you. As a catcher, are you even aware when guys are playing a foot off the track?
I'll be honest with you, D-Row. You're so concerned about on the mound trying to get that white ball to that dark brown or black glove that I never really ever turned around to even notice where they were playing. I was concerned about getting the guy out swinging the bat.
Getting a few steps off a second there. Now the pitch. So this is hauled in by the second baseman. Still anyone's ball game. 5-3 is our score as we take a look now at the starter comparison to see how these two guys fared in the matchup. So it's a tight spot here. First and second, one man out, and that'll bring up the former American League Rookie of the Year, Big Aaron Judge. Pickoff move to second. Runners back. Now a spin and another throw back to second, keeping particularly close tabs on him. He's set and the pitch. First pitch fastball swung on and missed 0-1. Good lead off a second there. Now the pitch. And whoa, this is off the third base bag. Oh, and this is past him down the line. A fair ball. The runner scores from second.
Yeah, and this late in the game, 6-3 feels pretty good. It's not locked up yet, but with a 3-run lead, you can feel comfortable handing it over to the back end of your bullpen to finish it off.
So we've got runners at the corners here, one away, and the next to bat, the Dominican-born catcher, Gary Sanchez. Here's the first pitch to him. Swing and a liner into right center. That's going to be a base hit. In to score is the runner from third, and that will stretch the lead to four now.
Hey, that's what you try and do as an offense. You get a 4-run lead, a grand slam ahead, Dan. But you're a former closer warming up when you see a 3-run lead, and then your offense gets it to four, and you know that save situation's gone out the window. Don't tell me that didn't hurt. Oh, it does.
Oh, it does, because, Dero, the only way you're going to get into this game is it has to be a save situation. You sit and watch 8 innings of baseball, you get up to warm up in the ninth, and you're all ready to go thinking, hey, I'm going to come in and get me a 3-out save, and all of a sudden you're out of the game because it's a 4-run lead. Of course you think about it as a reliever.
Stepping in now, Don Mattingly, driven deep at the wall. It is gone.
Well, the skipper called on him for a reason, and I can guarantee you one thing. That was not what he had in mind. First pitch, and it was out of here. That's a rough way to start your day at the office as a reliever.
Into the box, DJ LeMahieu. He swings and hits it foul off to the right and out of play. With this one almost in the books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty D, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-World, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did damage with it.
Striding in, Brett Gardner, 2-for-3 with a double on his line so far. First offering on its way. Pops this one up. Donaldson in foul ground, but this will land untouched. Hard hit ball to short. Swanson brings it in. Oh, in time, and they stop the bleeding as this side is retired. But not before five crossed the plate, with the big blow being this three-run home run. Home half of the eighth coming up. It's the Yankees 10 and the Braves 3. So digging in now, Freddie Freeman, and he's 0-for in this one, batting out of the three spot.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a ball, though, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
Batanzas is ready. 0-1 on its way. A shot down the first baseline. Two quick strikes, and now the 0-2. And he struck him out. Second time tonight now that he's been set down on strikes.
Now batting, third baseman.
One away for the Braves here in inning number 8. And this brings up the former American League MVP, Josh Donaldson. Lifted down the line in left. And that will end up a foul ball. He struck him out as well, so he's carving right through the heart of this lineup as there are two away now.
Good heater to strike him out there. He looks absolutely locked in to start this inning. That's back-to-back punch-outs on only 6 pitches.
In now, Dale Murphy. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He's 2-for-3 and looking for more here. The 1-0 home swing, and there it goes, deep to left. No chance at bringing this one back. And gone up into the second deck. A solo shot here to left. His first homer so far in the series, and this lead has been cut to just 6 now. Jumping in this one, that's the 4th to leave the yard so far.
Matty V, this is just one of those days where the ball seems to be fine. The hitters aren't playing, the pitchers aren't making very good pitches.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. It's all about executing pitches, and they're not doing it today. They're leaving a lot of balls over the heart of the plate. This offense, both offenses, are taking advantage.
Down and in here, 1 ball, no strikes. And a strike to even the count. 1-1. A swing and a blast to center field. No doubt about this one. Back-to-back home runs as that one's way out of here. So a solo home run by Nick Markakis, his second home run of the series, as they try to claw back. It's a 5-run deficit.
Yeah, they have everything to lose in this game, but it's obvious they have zero quitting. They're going to battle until the last out, and with that homer, they're that much closer to prolonging the series.
Standing in now, Ozzie Albies, as he lays off a fastball too low for ball one. He's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point. The 1-0. is laid off, but in there for strike one. Two out, nobody on. And that fastball's too much for him there. One and two.
Get it ready, big boy. This guy's throwing three digits right here. The best way I can help the fans is 90 to 92, you can usually see seams. 92 to 95, it starts to really quicken up on you. Over three.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. So they get a couple of runs on two hits, no errors, and no one left aboard. On to the ninth now in game three. It's the Yankees 10 and the Braves 5. Daniel Winkler enters from the pen to start the ninth inning as he'll try to keep the score right where it is heading to the bottom of the ninth. Jacoby Ellsbury will try to get his club a little ninth inning insurance as he'll grab a bat to pinch hit leading things off here. Ninth inning underway now as the first pitch is taken for a called strike. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan, D-Row, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage of it.
You know, D-Row, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
So the lineup flips over and digging in, Derek Jeter. He'll look to keep it going. 3-for-4 so far in the ballgame. And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1. One out, nobody on. Swing and a miss on the slider, and he's quickly behind, nothing and two.
Hey, guys, that's just a nasty pitch right there. I can't tell you how many nightmares I've had about nasty sliders, and that's exactly what that was right there.
Liner toward right center. And another base hit. He's 4-for-5 in this game.
Boy, talk about having a day, D-Row. He gets his fourth knock of the game, but mixed in with one of those four was a round tripper. Not a bad day.
Yeah, you have five, maybe a handful of games that you can throw out four knocks throughout the course of the year. Add in a tater to go with it. He's smiling. His food's going to taste better tonight.
Into the box now. Torres lifted in the air out towards left center. Murphy is in pursuit. He gets there and makes the play for the second out of the inning.
Next for the Yankees, the left fielder, David Rosario.
Now at the plate, David Rosario. He's 2-for-4 in the ballgame. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Line toward right center. And he will get there to make the running play, and that will end the inning. Yanks leave one. They still lead it, though, 10-5. Adam Ottavino, the 6'5 right-hander, takes over
now
on the mound.
Number zero, Adam Ottavino.
Ready now, Tyler Flowers. He'll lead things off here in the ninth with his guys in danger of falling into a very difficult to escape 3-0 deficit. Outside with the fastball, that's 1-0. And that's right there, and we're even at one. Here's the 1-1. Maybe a little jumpy there as he swings through the fastball. 1-2. Gets him looking up around the letters.
You know, I'm not quite sure how that strikeout will be scored, looking or swinging. He tried to check his swing, but I'm pretty sure the home plate umpire was ringing him up regardless.
Here's Ender Inciarte as he looks at a fastball that misses off the plate for ball one. He drew a base on balls his first time up. The 1-0 is taken, strike one. Bases are empty, one man out. Runs up and gets this one down. A barehanded play by LeMahieu. He is out.
Now batting, right fielder, David Justice.
Back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, David Justice. And he needs to make something happen. They're down to their final out here in the ninth. Ball to strike on the outer half, 0-1. Bouncer to the left side. LeMahieu's got it. Throw one to first, and the Yankees are one step away from a sweep. They take a commanding 3-0 lead here on the road as this one is over.
Anytime you can win a game, let alone on the road, you have to feel really good about yourself. It's not easy going into that other team's ballpark and coming out with a win, but they did just that.
Fellas, when you're on the big stage here at the World Series, you want to make sure you bring the A game, and this man right here certainly did. He's our Topps player of the game.
And Maddie, I think you're absolutely right. Some guys just seem to thrive under the bright lights of the World Series, while other guys fade into the background. He was brilliant in this one, and this is some well-earned recognition. Man, let me know if we got what you need.
This one ends with a 10-5 score. The New York Yankees take a commanding 3-0 lead in this World Series. James Paxton is credited with the win. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Our final line score tonight, first for the victorious Yankees, 10 runs on 14 hits. One error, they left two men on base. Time of the ball game, 4 hours exactly. Tonight's paid attendance at SunTrust Park, 41,084. The Braves thank you for your continued support and remind you to please drive home safely.